For cheap and reliable coins, check out buyultimateteam.com. Use the code Curtis for 10% off. Check the link in the description.
Big it up, YouTube. It's your boy, Curtis7, here for season number 2. Finally, I am back. I just want to say I apologize for the length of time it's got me from season 1 to season 2, because you guys already know I moved out, so I apologize for that. But anyways, lads, season 2 is finally here. Without further ado, let's suss out their team this season, what I'm thinking, and let's take a look at our team, and then let's take a look at our shortlist, what players we want to bring in to United. Let's go. Alright, finally lads, we are here at our squad. Now let's go through every single player and suss out what we're going to do with these players. Alright, first things first, De Gea, we're definitely going to keep him. No plans to sell him whatsoever. Alright, now Sam Johnson, lads, is a reserve goalkeeper. We are going to a season long loan him, put him out on loan. Because we've got Scafe on the as a reserve, and I think I've got another keeper as a backup in mind, but I'll tell you about that soon. Alright, Tyler Blackett. Now, I love this guy in real life, but unfortunately, FIFA, he ain't gonna cut it. So, instead of transfer listing him, I don't want to make it that unrealistic. I want to put him out on loan. I definitely want to keep him, but his potential is just so near what it's like in real life. So, definitely... unfortunately, don't have plans for him. But anyways, Phil Jones, keeping him. Alright, now, Michael Keane, want to keep him. But again, his potential's not that great, so I'm going to put him out for a season loan. Rojo, keeping. What a fantastic season he had. Chris Smalling, another defender who had a fantastic season. Stones, we just got him. Definitely keeping him. Thorpe, we've put him out on loan as well. Alright, now, James. Now, Reece James, again, gonna put him out on a long season loan. Luke Shaw, definitely the number one left back at United so far. Alright, Raphael at right back. I'm so glad that he stayed with us, so I'm definitely gonna keep Raphael. Valera, I'm gonna put Valera out on loan. He just came back from Real Madrid on loan, so hopefully we'll put him out back on loan. Now, Vermaal, we're going to put Vermaal back on loan as well. Put a lot of loanees out. Hopefully, a lot of these guys do go on loan, but I can't see them all going out on loan. All right, Angel Di Maria, obviously keeping him. Jesse Lingard, I do not want to loan out Jesse Lingard. Want to keep him. Juan Mata, now this is an interesting one. Juan Mata, he is worth a lot of money. And he hasn't been doing the business for us, lads. But I'm not going to put him on the transfer list, but I tell you what, if we do get a massive offer for Juan Mata, I'm definitely going to consider it. Alright, Pereira, another player we're going to put out on season loan. Now obviously lads, all these players going out on loan, they're not all going to go out on loan, so I know I'm going to keep a few of them, but I've got to list them just so they go on loan for the chance, you know what I mean? Nick Powell is 21 years of age. Oh, I'm not too sure what to do with Nicky Powell. I'm going to put him on loan just for now, but I definitely want to use Nicky Powell. Alright, Daily Blind, keeping. Fellaini, going to be keeping. He was immense come later on in that second season. Got no plans to sell Marouane Fellaini whatsoever. Carrick, I could sell Carrick, but it'll be too unrealistic, and that's the same with Darren Fletcher. Now, Tom Cleverley is going to be the first player I put on that transfer list. Unfortunately, Tom Cleverley, we're stacked in the midfield now, and I'm even looking at other midfielders, and unfortunately, my friend, you are just not going to cut it at Manchester United, so sorry, Tom Cleverley. Ander Herrera, obviously, you know, starting in the midfield, going to keep him. Rothwell, I'm going to put him out on loan. To be honest, I don't even have plans to use him. Maybe I could sell him. Now, Strootman, obviously, we just bought him in the January transfer window. Yanezai, definitely gonna keep Adnan Yanezai. Wilfred Zaha, I am not doing anything with him. I have big plans for Wilf, so definitely keeping him. Nani, now Nani is a player that I'm definitely gonna be keeping. I'm not gonna put him out on loan. I'm gonna give him a chance at United, see what he can do. But a player that I'm not gonna take a chance with is Antonio Valencia. Unfortunately, lads, his bad form, he won the worst player of the season last year. I am going to put him on the transfer list. So, sorry, Antonio. Now, Javier Hernandez, lads. The big question, what am I going to do with Javier Hernandez? Well, I've been thinking long and hard, and I reckon, lads, we can get the best out of Javier Hernandez. There's no need to put him out on loan. There's no need to sell him. I want him to prove himself at Manchester United. He's got one season with us to prove himself, and this is going to be it. So we are keeping Javier Hernandez. Now, another player we're not going to put out on loan. Oh, actually, we are going to put out Will Keane. Will Keane, you will be going out on loan, my friend. Rooney keeping Wilson. Now, this guy, I ain't putting out on loan. I ain't selling him. We are definitely going to use Wilson. He grows a lot in his career mode, especially as the years go on. But definitely a keeper, James Wilson. And obviously, last on the list is Robin Van Persie. Look at that. He's worth $50 million. Overall 90 player of the year for us last season, lads. Obviously, we're going to be keeping Robin Van Persie. So, but anyways, lads, that's what I've got planned for this squad at the start of this window. Who knows what the way it pans out at the end of the window. But for now, that's what I'm going with. Maybe I could sell one or two players during this window. But until then, lads, let's take a look at my shortlist. All right, so here we go, lads. My shortlist. Now, everybody on this shortlist is on here just so I can take them into consideration. I won't be getting everybody on this list, so that's for sure. So you can calm down a little bit. They're just on here so I can take a look at them and consider them. But anyways, now, first one, lads, is Danny Alves. Now, we need a backup for Rafael. Now, arguably, Rafael could be backup for Danny Alves. He's been linked with Manchester United. But again, I'm taking a look at him. I don't want him right away, but he would be a welcome addition into the club. Now, talking about priorities, you guys really wanted me to sign Mats Hummels in January, but it was so expensive. Dortmund wanted $50 million. We don't have that kind of money right now. But I will take another crack at Dortmund for Mats Hummels. He would be fantastic. But if we don't get Mats Hummels, we've got another realistic target. That's Ron Vlaar. Now, I don't really want to take Ron Vlaar because, look, he's 30. He's decreasing. You know, he's in bad form. But if I have to, we will. Now, another player that's slowly in real life being linked back to Manchester United away from Barcelona is Gerard Pique. You know, 28, you know, he used to play United. He's got a big, big bond with Sir Alex Ferguson. I could see, potentially, Gerard Pique coming back to United. Maybe. It's definitely realistic. All right, now, at left back, guys, we've got Jethro Willems. Now, Jethro is not really, linked to Manchester United in real life, but we need backup for Luke Shaw. Now, Rojo can play at left back, but predominantly Rojo is a centre half, so it would be nice to have that speed and pace at left back. And mate, Jethro Willems, 21 years of age, got a bit of speed about him. He would be a great addition at left back. Now, a player that was linked to pretty much every big club in the Premier League last summer was William Carvalho. Now, he was linked with United heavily, but we didn't end up getting him, so I've got him on the list. We're taking him into consideration. Now, that's the same with Pjanic. Now, Pjanic, again, linked with United forever and a day, but we don't ever seem to end up getting him. And that goes with the same as this bloke, Arturo Vidal. Very, very popular in the comments down below. You guys really want me to get Arturo Vidal, but the biggest obstacle, lads, is he has joined Manchester City. I totally forgot about that. Last summer, he joined City, so in his career mode. So I want Arturo Vidal. Will he make that jump from blue to red? Arturo Vidal. Strootman's been good, but he hasn't really impressed me that much, to be honest, Strootman. So if we can get that other midfielder in, like Arturo Vidal, that would be magnificent. Now, talking about backups. Now, if we do sell Juan Mata, we need a new cam. And boy, oh boy, oh boy, if Ross Barkley could fill that hole. He would be fantastic if we could get Ross. Radamel Falcao, la 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 la. Nah, seriously, Radamel Falcao, I want this guy back at Manchester United. We had him last season, but he was always injured, and I want him to have another crack at this pick. But $37 million, whew, boy, oh boy, oh boy. Do we have enough money to bring back Radamel Falcao? going to be really, 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 really difficult. I don't think we can, but I really want to. Next player, lads, is Memphis Depay. Now, linked with United ever since Van Gaal took over the job, and the World Cup that Memphis had as well was unbelievable. We got a lot of wingers at the minute, but we don't have a lot of good wingers. If we got some good cash left over, because no doubt Memphis Depay is going to be really, really expensive, we might go and get him. But until then, lads, I think our number one target is our defence, then the midfield, and then up front. So I think that's the way this transfer window is going to pan out, but you never know how it's going to pan out. Now, for all those you wondering about Cristiano Ronaldo, because a lot of you said bring him back to the club, yes, I do want Cristiano Ronaldo at Manchester United just as much as you do, but I don't think it'll be really realistic if it happened right away. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying no, but I'm saying maybe in January, maybe next season, just not right now. Anyways, lads, let's kick off this season and make some signings. All right, lads, we've got an email from the board. They said our budget for this season is $33,160,000 on wages. Yeah, that's not much at all, is it? Let's be real. Jeez, it's going to be a struggle. So the board have said they want us to win the domestic cup. Yeah, no worries. All right, mate. And they the Champions Cup, they'll be expecting us to reach the semi-finals of the Champions League. Wow, that's going to be tough. Champions League football, lads, it's back. And yeah, they want us to make the semi-finals. Not going to be easy at all, is it? So first things first, lads, we're going to make an offer here to Mats Hummels. Now, they want Dortmund $43.5 million to $50 million, basically. And we don't have that kind of money at all, do we? So what we're going to have to do is put a player up for sale for a swap. And the player is Antonio Valencia plus, I reckon, let's go with $25 million. I know that's nowhere near the offer, but you just have to try your luck in this game. Hopefully, the deal can get done. I doubt it, though. Now, Arturo Vidal, a very popular choice. Now, he's worth $18.5 million, his value, so I'm just going to go straight up bank $20 million, offer that to City, see what they have to say. Now, Radamel Falcao. Now, obviously, we haven't got nowhere near the money to get Radamel, so I'm going to see if we can get him back on loan for a full season. Seeing if so, Monaco did it once before, let's see if they'll do it again. You just got to try your luck. Now, Jetro Willems, we need him, so I'm going to offer PSV $2 million, and let's start the bidding war, basically. So, PSV want more money for Willems, Monaco don't want to loan Falcao, and Dortmund are not interested in Valencia. It's going to be a long summer. Alright, so we're going to have to buy Radamel Falcao if we want him. We don't have really the money for him. So the only thing I can do is just blow our whole budget on Radamel Falcao, $33 million. If they say no, looks like we can't get Radamel. So we got an email back from City saying that they are willing to sell Vidal to us, but they want $29.5 million. It's a lot of money, and I really, really want Vidal at United. So halfway would be $25 million, and I reckon we can get Vidal for $25 million. Just gotta try your luck. That's $4.5 million less. Now, Jetro Willems, I'm gonna give up Vermaal. We're not really gonna use Vermaal. He hasn't got the potential to be a United player on FIFA anyways. So, $2 million plus Vidal to PSV for Willems. Hopefully, that could get the deal done. Got an offer here from Napoli for Raphael. $12.5 million. You guys know Raphael is my number one right back. Ain't happening. Alright, lads, some bad news. Monaco, they do not want to sell Radamel Falcao. So, we're just going to have to push Radamel to the side just for a little bit. Disappointing, really. Got an offer here from Wolfsburg. They want De Gea, and I am definitely going to reject that. No chance. $17 million. You're having a laugh. All right, City have come back and they said they are not budging on that $29.5 million for Arturo Vidal. Ah, mate, I really want a tour every day too. It's just a lot of money. Geez, what do we do? I don't even want to trade a player because it's City. I don't even want to consider swapping a player. All right, let's offer 27.5 million. That's pushing the budget right there. All right, there we go. PSV are not interested in Vermaal, so that's all right because we're going to offer for him to go out on loan anyways here to Ipswich, so we're going to accept that. And we also got an offer from Cardiff, I believe. Oh, no, Watchful for Tom Thorpe. So both of those players going to go out on loan. So get some experience, lads. Still unacceptable. Oh, mate, Arturo Vidal, what are we going to do with you? 29.5 million is a lot of money when you've only got 33 million in the bank. Ugh. I'm going to have to, I need to think about this one. So I've been thinking, Mats Hummels or Arturo Vidal? Even though I personally want Arturo Vidal more than Mats Hummels, I think you guys, the team, needs Mats Hummels more than Arturo Vidal. So we're going to offer Mats Hummels 30 million. And still, I don't think that's going to be enough. So we'll see how we go. So here we go. We've got an offer here from West Ham for Tom Cleverley. They're offering 2.8. Just give me his value, Sam Allardyce, and you can take Tom Cleverley. 3.2 million, and he's all yours. So there we go, lads. Dortmund are not budging. They want 49 million for Mats Hummels. We don't even have that kind of money. So, lads, looks like we're going to go ahead and get Arturo Vidal. Tottenham want Javier Hernandez. I wouldn't mind be willing to sell Javier Hernandez, but I think I want a lot of money if I'm going to sell Javier Hernandez. But I do want to use him, so I'm going to reject this offer from Tottenham. So I've gone back to City for Arturo Vidal, improved my offer to 29 million. That should get him across the line. There we go, lads. West Ham have received the offer and they are going to match the deal for 3.2 million for Tom Cleverley. He is sold to West Ham. Good luck, Tom. Here we go. Dortmund are interested in Javier Hernandez. Now, this could be a key. This could be very, very interesting. We want Hummels. They want Hernandez. I can feel a trade in the balance here, lads. So, first things first, I'm going to counter offer this. Yeah, I don't want to sell Hernandez, but at the same time, I want Hummels. So, I'm going to be cheeky, and I'm going to ask I'm going to ask 40 million. It's a lot of money. I know that. He's not worth anywhere near that. I know that. But neither is Hummels. 50 million. Come on. You know? So let's give that to Dortmund and let's see what they have to say. So that's got me thinking now. Dortmund want Hernandez. We want Hummels. And yes, we did that counter offer. But I just want to put this offer to Dortmund. Just trying my luck right here. No money, straight swap Hernandez for Mats Hummels. Let's see if they'll be willing to take the bait. Imagine if that happens. Imagine. All right, so Dortmund have come back and they said the most they're willing to spend on Hernandez is 21.5 million, which we're going to go right ahead and reject that. No chance. Way too cheap. City not budging 1 millimeter. They want that 29.5 million. So let's go. Come on, Arturo Vidal. That should do the job. So I got an email back from Dortmund. They want Hernandez plus 25 million. They're having a laugh. No chance. There we go, lads. Manchester City have accepted the 29.5 million for Arturo Vidal. Let's go and pay his wages. Let's make him a Manchester United player. Tyler Blackett going on loan to Preston North End. So get some experience there, lads. David Beckham was on loan to P&E as well. So a little bit of information for you. All right, got an offer here from Juventus. They want Antonio Valencia. We need some cash. And to be honest, lads, we don't really need Antonio. So we're going to counter offer this. We're going to counter offer to 8.5 million, what his value is, to be fair, and be sad, but, you know, unfortunately, he's not good enough. And Chris Smalling, Everton want him for 8 million. We need defenders, and wow, that's huge. Chris Smalling's a great player. I'm going to have to go reject that. Great player. He was immense for us at the back last year. I thought he was head and shoulders above Phil Jones at the back. So, unfortunately, I'm going to have to reject that, Everton. There we go, lads. Arturo Vidal has accepted. He is now officially a Manchester United player. Welcome to the Theatre of Dreams, son. And there we go, lads. Juventus have accepted the deal. Valencia will be joining Paul Pogba, Tevez, and Patrice Evra, the ex-Manchester United players at Juventus. So, good luck to the future, Valencia. All right, lads. So, I've been thinking about a way how to get Mats Hummels to Manchester United. Now, obviously, we have got no wage whatsoever. But I think we really need that solid defender at the back. The number one man, the Nemanja Vidić, Rio Ferdinand player at the back. We don't have anyone like that. We've just got a bunch of headless chooks who are youngsters at the back in Rojo, Smalling, Jones. We need someone at the back who's just going to be the boss. And that's Hummels. We really need Hummels, lads. And unfortunately, we're going to have to put a play up for sale that's going to be controversial. But in the same time, lads, he has been linked away to Manchester United very recently. A lot too. Can he play in? He's not really a starter. And to be honest, lads, he wasn't even playing in our starting 11 last season. So, to swap a player, a non-starting player, to bring in a starting 11 player, I think the deal's got to be done, lads. So, unfortunately, it's going to break my heart, lads. We're going to have to put up for swap Juan Mata. I think Juan Mata, great player. I love Juan Mata. But he's been linked away to Juventus. You know, Van Gaal isn't too keen on him. We all know Jose Mourinho wasn't too keen on him. To bring in Mats Hummels' starting boss at the back, you know, for Juan Mata, who's not even in our starting 11, you know, I think it's a smart move, lads. So, breaks my heart, but I'm going to have to submit that. See what Dortmund have to say. All right, the first pre-season friendly, lads. We always sim the pre-season friendlies. I don't really care about them. Just want no injuries. I don't even care if we lose them all. Just no injuries, please. All right, we're just starting off with their team. And 2-2 draw. Yes, no injuries, thank God. 2-2 draw. Get in. Oh, my God. They've accepted Dortmund. Just like that. No money. They just want one matter. Oh my gosh. Mats Hummels. This deal looks like it's set to be on. Give him a 5-year deal. Let's just get him in the team. 5-year deal. Crucial. Whoa. Imagine if this deal goes ahead. All right, lads. The next friendly is we're at home to Napoli. Again, no injuries. And we win 1-0 thanks to Strootman. So get in. There we go, lads. Mats Hummels has accepted. He is going to be officially a Manchester United player. Welcome to the Theatre of Dreams, my friend. Wow, that's massive. That is massive. We have landed Mats Hummels and Arturo Vidal. Wow. It's going to be sad Juan Mata's not with us now, lads. But like I said, we're bringing in a starting 11 boss at the back. You know, and we're getting rid of a player who's not even in our starting 11. So, you know, it's a bit realistic in the sense that Mats Hummels heavily linked with United. And Juan Mata is linked away with United as well. So, definitely controversial, but a decision that had to be made. And I think definitely, lads, that is in our favour. So, now, obviously, we're going to need to replace Juan Mata now. Obviously, we haven't got 40 million to go out and get a player like him. But the next best thing you do is you get a player that can turn out exactly like Juan Mata. So, Ross Barkley is the answer. In my opinion, you know, English, you know, heavily linked with the big clubs in England. And I reckon £10 million, we're going to start a bidding war with Everton. So, Ross Barkley, great, great potential he has. So, Everton quickly reject that deal for Ross Barkley. They want more money, obviously. So, let's go and see if we can approve our bid. We don't have much money. Let's just go back with $12.5 million and let's see if that tickles Everton's fancy. Well, there we go. Everton have rejected that and they said they want $21 million for Ross Barkley, which is a little bit out of our price range at the minute. So I've gone back to Everton with an improved bid of $15 million for Ross Barkley. I don't think that'll get the job done. It's a lot of money, but just gotta try it luck. All right, lads, we've come to the first game of the Premier League. We're away at the Hawthorns to West Brom, but you're gonna have to wait to the next episode to catch that, unfortunately. But lads, what an episode it's been. Let's take a look at my squad. We've had some massive outs for the club in one matter. Antonio Valencia, very sad to see. But lads, let's take a look at my squad right now. This is the team that I'll be using to play against West Brom. Van Persie up top in career best form. Wayne Rooney back in the cam. We've got Di Maria on the left, and we've got Adnan Yanezé on the right. You know, the Young Player of the Year award there. He won it. Mate, fantastic season he had last season. And in the middle of the park, lads, we've got Ander Herrera and Arturo Vidal. That is going to be an unbelievable partnership. Luke Shaw left back. Rojo and Hummels at the back there. Rafael right back. And De Gea in goals as well. So, lads, what a team. And on the bench, let me just show you the whole team. Hernandez, Wilson on the bench. Nani, Zaha. We've got Fellaini, Daley Blind, and Phil Jones on the bench. Look, we are depth in massively, depth, I should say. Will Keane, Strootman, the whole list. Look at that. It is just a massive team this season. We're going to need it. Champions League, you know, FA Cup, Carling Cup, Premier League. We're going to need this massive squad. But I think, lads, for now, we have done perfectly in the window. I wouldn't mind seeing a replacement for Juan Mata in the cam, but even if we don't get a player like Ross Barkley, it's not the end of the world, but ideally that's what I would like. But until the next episode, lads, I appreciate it if you could drop a like for all this hard work and all this editing that goes into this career mode. Yes, I'm finally back doing career mode too, so that deserves a thumbs up in its own. But anyways, lads, make sure you follow me on Twitter, on Facebook, and all those wonderful things. Until next episode, lads, I'm your boy, Curtis Seven. Take care. No boots.